through their own properties, protons, neutrons, and electrons, whatever they are made of, come together to form atoms. Atoms, through their attractive and repulsive properties, come together to form molecules. Molecules, through their interaction, form cells. By combining a great deal of pressure to pyruvic acid and water, an enclosure is formed which protects molecules, creating an environment in which they could theoretically form cells. In the Miller-Urey experiment, the chemists Stanley Miller and Harold Urey were able to create 22 amino acids with water, methane, ammonia, and hydrogen by combining a lot of heat and pressure to this soup. Without a protective enclosure, the amino acids quickly get broken down. Bob Hazen's experiment with pyruvic acid created an environment similar to that which forms amino acids. However they are made, cells then can combine to form tissues, such as algae or certain types of seaweed. This is a multicellular organism, but with only one type of cell. After that, tissues then combine to form multicellular organisms with multiple types of cells. This all emerges from the crude rule sets of individual cells interacting with each other. Then, the organisms themselves get together to form societies like schools of fish, herds of buffalo, flocks of birds, hives of insects, packs of wolves, or tribes of apes. Including humans. For centuries, the flocking of birds confounded ornithologists. Many bizarre theories were put forward, such as the common soul, thought transference, or the chorus line hypothesis. In 1986, Craig Reynolds programmed the basic rule set of bird behavior into a supercomputer at the time, and the birds flocked. The solution emerged from the simple behavior of each bird in the simulation. Human crowds work the same way. A line of people will form as a result of one person following the other, trying to get through the crowd, doing his own thing. There are no commandments. It just happens. It just emerges. Civilization is built up the same way. A man learns to farm, then realizes he can grow more by carrying water to his crops. Other men then realize the same thing. As a result, they all get together and work out an irrigation system that will work for all of them and will prevent overuse by any individual farmer somehow. Human civilization is an emergent complexity. It is not mandated from the top down. It is built up. The rational self-interest of individuals is what created irrigation and any type of infrastructure. Before states, larger ports were created when shipping companies got together and made ports to benefit from an economy of scale. again working out allotments to prevent the tragedy of the commons. Trade networks developed when individuals realized they could make more money by taking goods from one area to another. So what is the state? The state in this sense is a false certainty that stems from a misunderstanding of how the world really works. The first states were religious, and the first kings were connected to God in some way. Either they were demigods, chosen by a god, had a revelation from a god, or were the high priest. This god connection gave the first kings the legitimacy in the eyes of the masses and a mirage of certainty. The idea that humans must be ordered from top down stems from the idea that life itself is ordered from the top down, either from a singular god or from various gods assigned to regulate certain things, like Poseidon, Zeus, etc. The irony, of course, is that the state itself emerges. That which denies emergence emerges. Each individual wants things to be ordered and nice and takes actions to make his life ordered and nice. But unlike birds, men can think abstractly. This abstract thinking gives them the ability to use language, make maps and the like. But it also gives them the ability to dream of genies, angels, a benevolent state, pixies and gods. But of course the rational self-interest of the people, who are perceived as being agents of the state, is why there is such abuse in the state. The same principles that predict how life and human civilization will emerge and how the state will emerge also predict how individuals, given artificially high levels of trust and authority by the masses, as a result of being seen as the state, will abuse their power. Nothing can be omniscient because it cannot calculate itself, and the state cannot calculate society. As even if it were made up of every single member of society, the state cannot calculate itself. It takes more than one person to calculate the behavior of one person. And the notion that the state can calculate subjective demand better than an emergent matrix of prices and ostracisms is theistic. AIDS emerged, the state emerged. I'm not defending all things that exist. The problem is that a state program exists in a market, but does not emerge from it. It is not market emergent, but emergent from a mass hallucination. Emerge from what is the relevant question, because it is probably calibrated to it. Those who support the state will claim, as I did, that they don't put the state on a pedestal, but they do. State police are good, non-state police lead to chaos. That's the implicit theism of 99% of statists. The state is seen as this cytoplasm, a structure in the background, a fallback of safety net. This is illusory. Whether or not you believe in God doesn't matter. Maybe God could centrally plan an economy, but That's not what we are talking about. We are talking about mere men.